categories of weight, materials, whatever, of recycling, and it's pretty awesome. Lacrosse has been participating since 2009, and currently we are ranked 103 in just the overall competition benchmark, which is pretty cool because there's two divisions and obviously we're pretty competitive.
In recent years, has Recycle Mania created any other green programs?
Well, since Recycle Mania has started, not directly from Recycle Mania, but there have been a lot of green fund projects. So all of the green recycling, like receptacles, that's the word I'm trying to look for, that are around campus that have been added in the last few years. And the vermicomposting is really good. I don't know how steady that program's been so far this year, but I think that's a really good addition. And I think adding I don't know if they still have the totes in the dorms, but the reusable bags have also been added.
Recycle Mania isn't mandatory, but a greener lifestyle leaves a greener campus. This has been Aaron Ingstrand, Katie Butson, and Matt Davis for WMCM.
So if you find yourself with any paper, plastic, or cans, please recycle them in one of the many receptacles on campus. Coming to the UWL campus is the Food for Thought Brown Bag Lunch Film Series. You can enjoy a fun and stimulating conversation on this month's topic, immigration. You can bring your food and bring your thoughts starting tomorrow, March 9th, in the Port Hall in Cartwright. Students can head on down to enjoy a friendly conversation for free. And tomorrow's topic will be immigration, and next month's will be hate and bias. If you want more information about this event, call Amanda Goodenough with 608-785-5093. And we will have more information in the show. Each week, the WMCM crew goes out and talks to your fellow peers in a segment we call Campus Insight. This week, we ask students what they're doing for spring break.
Conkle, and we're here from WMCM for Campus Insight, asking people what they're doing for spring break.
Alrighty, well, for my spring break, I'm hoping to go home and work 40 hours as an office assistant because I am broke. So that's my exciting plans, and to see other friends and family and eat sushi. Ooh, yeah.
I'm going to the Dells to stay at the Wilderness with my friends to do some crazy shenanigans.
My name's Ravi. I'm going to Iowa for the National Track and Field Meet for spring break. It's going to be fun.
Okay, so for spring break this year, 2012, I'm actually going to Hawaii with my family, Maui in specific. So we're pretty much just going to do some surfing, lay on the beach, you know, hit up a few luaus.
Looks like people have some exciting spring breaks up ahead. Have a great spring break. This is WMCM's Campus Insight.
Look for the WMCM crew around campus for your chance to have your opinions heard on next week's Campus Insight. And now here's Courtney Duerwachter with a review of the movie Midnight in Paris.
Today's movie review is the Oscar-nominated film Midnight in Paris, directed by Woody Allen. The movie follows a young engaged couple traveling in Paris before they are about to be married. Gil, played by Owen Wilson, is a writer struggling to perfect his first novel. He's about to marry Inez, played by Rachel McAdams, a young, spirited woman ready to take Paris by storm. While Inez goes dancing one night with friends, Gil walks the city. At the strike of midnight, he is picked up by a car full of enchanting and vibrant people. He is brought to a party where he meets people he never thought he'd meet. Every night, he is taken into a different time, closer to the people he was never supposed to know, and farther away from the woman he was supposed to spend the rest of his life with. Before I give too much away, let's go ahead and take a look at the trailer.
I mean, this is unbelievable. There's no city like this in the world.
You're in love with a fantasy.
I'm in love with you.
What are you doing here?
Dad's here on business, and we just decided to reload along.
Oh!
That's great. We can spend some time together.
I think we have a lot of commitments, but I'm sure it's... Well,
what?
If I'm not mistaken, Rodin's work was influenced by his wife, Camille.
Rose was the wife.
No, he was never married to Rose.
I hope you're not going to be as antisocial tomorrow.
I'm not quite as taken with him as you are.
I mean, he's a pseudo-intellectual.
Slightly more tannic than the 59. I prefer a smoky feeling.
Carol and I are going to go dancing.
Dancing?
We heard of a great place. Interested?
No. I don't want to be a killjoy, but I need a
get a little fresh air.
What time did you get in last night?
Not that late. Yeah, I'll probably end up going on another little hike tonight.
Where'd Gil run off to?
I've been walking around Paris.
Where do you think Gil goes every night?
He walks and gets ideas.
Mm-hmm. Why are you so dressed up?
I was just doing a little writing.
You dress up and put on cologne to write?
Because you know how I think better in the shower and I get the positive ions going in there.
I had a private detective follow him.
And what happened?
I don't know. The detective agency says the detective is missing.
I'm in a very perplexing situation.
I thought this movie was captivating and witty. It showed the glamorous side of the 1920s and why many people call it the Golden Age. Owen Wilson once again proved he can make any movie charming. Kathy Bates was alluring as usual with her portrayal as Gertrude Stein. Rachel McAdams was great as the whiny and unpleasant fiancé. The way Pablo Picasso and Ernest Hemingway were portrayed was spot on. This movie proved that you're never too old to live a life you've always dreamed of, and there's always a second chance at love. I definitely recommend this film to anyone that wants to escape reality for a little while. I believe it was worthy of its Oscar nomination and truly shows how wonderful of a place Paris is to follow your dreams and your heart. Stay tuned to WMCM. Emily Marotz will be back with this weekend's weather.
L-Fact, University of Wisconsin-La Crosse is ranked the number 2 college in the Midwest.
UW-La Crosse is ranked number 34 for out-of-state students among public universities nationwide.
UW-La Crosse is ranked as one of the most military-friendly schools in the nation.
UW-La Crosse is number 24 among medium colleges and universities for Peace Corps volunteers.
And for this week's weather, so today was pretty nice out, actually. Not partly cloudy, high only of 47, but a low of 30 tonight. Tomorrow we have some rain and snow showers coming up, but a little cooler, high of only 38, low 27. But this weekend's supposed to warm up, so it'll be pretty nice. Saturday, windy, but a high of 60 and a low of 40. And for Sunday, a few rain showers, not too bad. Still high, pretty mild, and a nice way to kick off our spring break this week with a high of 51 and a low of 44. And then we'll be now Summer Steiner with this week's interview.
Thanks, Emily. So today I'm here with Matt Evensen from Campus Climate, and he's going to tell us a little bit more about what Courtney mentioned earlier, the Brown Bag Lunch film series. So thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So would you like to start out and just tell us a little bit about what the Brown Bag
sure.
Lunch film series actually is?
Sure. The Brown Bag Lunch film series is a program that's come out of Campus Climate, really focusing on ways to facilitate discussions about some social justice issues, this one being about immigration. So what we're hoping to do is to show a documentary and then to have a discussion and facilitate a discussion afterwards.
Cool. Mm-hmm. So what is tomorrow's film?
Tomorrow's film is actually an episode of 30 Days, which is a television series that used to be on FX featuring Morgan Spurlock, who did the documentary Supersize Me. And basically it puts someone who